Okay, so the com so what was the value of the mesh we got?
12.155.
Okay, there are two meshes, right? The bigger mesh is
16.
16.3 and the smaller mesh is 48.
48.
Together
14.
we got 12.5 ohms, right?
Yes, sir.
12.5 ohms. And the pipe electrode, how each pipe electrode is how much? 54.8 ohms, huh? So
Yes.
8 of them in parallel initially, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you got close to 7.49 ohms, right?
Yes.
Plate, okay, for the time being we'll assume each plate to be like 120 ohms, so two plate will be around 60 ohms. Then straight length we have 2 meter, one straight strip is how much? 28 ohms, huh? How much? One straight strip 68 ohms.
20. One straight strip.
2 meter strip how much?
68. Yeah,
68.
68.
So there are 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 2 meters, so
17.
17 ohms. So now my R1 is how much? 12.5. My R2 is 7.4. My R3 is 60. My R4 is 17. And all these together gave me around 3.5 ohms, right?
Yes.
And now because 3.5 ohms, it has to be 1 ohm, right? Is my target. So I've added this blue color, another 4 pits. And each of these pit was around how much? Each pit was 54.8, 54.8. So approximately 12 ohms, right? 17,
4.5.
so 18, together this will be 18 ohms, right? This extra 4 pits. So if I add 1, 2, 3, now if I add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 plus 5, 10. 12 pits. If I have 12 pits, pipe electrodes, what will be the total resistance? What will be R2? R2 value will change, right?
Sir, it will be 54.8 divided by 12, right?
No, but I told you yesterday, no, that when you have pits in parallel, the resistance will be, I told this formula, no? Which one? This one, rods in parallel.
Okay.
Okay. Actually, you have to use this formula, but now let us take it as 54.8 divided by 12. How much is it?
4.56.
4.56. Okay, let me take it as 5 only. Okay, so now what will be the resistance of this? 1 by 12.5, 1 by 5, 1 by 60, 1 by 70.
It's 2.8.
2.8, huh? So 3.5 became 2.8 ohms, right? So still I am not able to achieve, right? Now what do I do next? No,
We
what if
treat
we add
this,
another plate?
plate will
or we
not help
treat the
much.
soil.
Plate will not help much. See, other one more this one is two option. Let's say one is I can run one more ring around it. That is one option. Now let's say I have one more ring, one more mesh. Now this mesh is how much? 10. Now between here, let's say I have 3 meter gap. So 10 plus 6, 16. This is 16 meter. 26 meter. So find out 26 into 16 is how much?
416.
Huh?
416.
416, huh? So 416 meter square mesh. What will be the resistance?
Sir, that what will be the length?
Length is you add, it is the perimeter. 26 into 2 plus 16 into 2. 52 plus 32. That is 84.
Okay.
84. So what will be the resistance on new value? What is the resistance of the mesh now? Can you tell me? Are you able to calculate? Point 443 into rho by root A plus rho by L. A is how much? 4. 26 into 16. How much is that? Okay.
6.72 ohms.
Point 8. Others got this?
Yes, sir.
How much you got? Mr. Shankar, how much you got? How much you got? Six point, how much you got?
6.8, sir. Sorry. Sorry.
6.8 ohms. Okay, 6.8 ohms. Now, 2.8 in parallel with 6.8 is how much? 2.8 in parallel with 6.8.
For 1.85 ohms.
1.85 ohms, okay.
0.147.
Okay, I got.
Sir, I got 0.54, then 1/0.54. I don't know.
It is 1/2.8 and 1/6.8, right? So it is 1.98 ohms, so close to 2 ohms.
1.984, yeah, that's right.
Okay, close to 2 ohms. Mr. Armugam, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Almost 2 ohms.
Okay, Mr. Enamul is traveling, he's not able to check, no problem. See, basically now this is not giving me full solution, no?
Yeah.
Okay, so what I can do? What I
Sir,
can tell
can
you?
we in this case can we go for a treated earthquake?
Yes, see, it treated earthquake depend on the this one. For example,
Okay.
whether some people will not allow treated earthquake. If they don't allow, then you have to add some more earthquakes here. Okay.
Okay.
If they don't allow, add some more pits here. Okay. Or
Okay.
the other option is, I will go for treated earthquake. I will insert. I will not go for this.
Sir, can I ask you a question?
Yeah, please.
Sir, when we do the earthing resistivity, you do the like couple, three, four methods are there, but most commonly we use the Wiener method, right?
Yes, yes, Wiener 4-pin method.
Yeah, so that in that 4-pin method, it means if you find it out the like in different spacing, if
yeah.
one of the spacing, if the resistivity is lower,
yeah.
we can go for a deep electrode in the sense rather than 3 meters. Maybe when we do the 6 meter or 10 meter, say for example 6 meter, when we do the Wiener method, the resistivity was lower. So if you do that kind of a earth electrode couple of places, will it reduce it by your experience?
Yes, you are correct. That is also, see, one is this one, like add more pit or add one more ring. The one more thing, like what you said, is also correct. I can go for a higher depth here also. Like in one of the project also, I had done this. I had increased the pit, the length.
Because when we do the 4-pin method, it's different distances, right? So that distances is almost equal to how much depth and what from, say for example, from 4 meters to 6 meters. If you get lesser, if you use that kind of an electrode, reaching that exact 4 to 6 meters.
See, actually, but when you do this calculation, no, in this calculation we are assuming the soil to be single layer homogeneous soil.
Okay.
That whereas if you do the use some software and all, there you can have multi-layer soil. Okay. So here what we can do is we can increase the electrode instead of 3 meter. Let us take one example. Let me take this electrode as 6 meter. Find out what is the resistance you are getting. One electrode, pipe electrode. Take the pipe electrode. This one. We have the formula. Take this as this one. Instead of 3 meter, so make this as 6 meter. You see how much you will get. Actually, I'm having here, no, 6 meter length. How much? I think it will be almost maybe 35 ohms or something. We can calculate and see. Are you able to calculate? Anybody calculate?
31.05.
31.05. Okay, 31.05, right? Now this 31.05. If I have how many pits? How many pit I'm having here?
12, right?
Let's assume 1, 2, 3, 4, 12 pits only in parallel. 31.05, 12 pits in parallel is how much?
2.58.
How much?
Yeah, 2.58.
Okay, 2.58. Now, this 7.4, I will change it to. I will. Okay, let me change this to. How much? 2.58. So what is the resistance now? 12.5, 2.58, 60 and 17. How much I will get? 1 by 12.5 parallel with 2.58 in parallel with 60 and 17. How much?
1.84.
1.84. Now, I think by increasing the depth, okay, I cannot go beyond this depth also. See, when you can go for a slightly more depth also. And you can check the resistance. So it is like, see, actually there are number of solution. Increase the number of pit, add more horizontal conductor, add one more ring, increase the depth. Or instead of this, if the client agrees, go for treater pit or go for deep borer pit till you get water table. So like this, you have number of this one. So whatever you learnt, you have to apply all of them. Then finally, you have to check each solution, economics of each solution. Okay. How do you check the economics of each solution? You have to get a rough BOQ and you have to estimate. So finally, it is not that you cannot get below 1 hour. You'll have n number of solutions. And in each solution, you will have different cost. And it may vary from region to region. So you have to check the cost and finally give a technically, economically viable solution. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, we will move to the this one. Okay, now see, in many industries, no, they have standardized. They have standardized different sizes. For example, for a tank, they use typical 40x6 GI flat. Or this copper, they will have 70 to 185 mm square insulated copper. If it is a vessel or a vent and flare, same way like a tank. Then pipe rack, they'll use 20 by 5 flat or they'll use 25 mm square insulated cable. Same like pipeline. Motor push button station, no? Normally, they will use a 16 mm square wire. And you can also use, don't use a flat for motor push button station, but if you're using iron, please use stranded instead of using solid. If you use solid, then termination is a problem. And lighting junction box, I for lighting junction box and all, I don't prefer iron. It is better you use copper wire. Okay, insulated. For motor, see motor, normally you have to do the calculation, okay? If a motor is far away from your panel, short circuit level will be less. If motor is close to your panel, short circuit level will be high. So for motor, you will do the calculation. Lighting fixture, okay, use the cable. Lighting pole, better use cable. Transformer body and transformer neutral and all, is generator body and all purely based on size, okay? Then, mechanical package item, any mechanical package item, they are using 25 mm square. UPS neutral, please do the sizing. Generator neutral, all neutrals, earthing, please do the sizing based on the short circuit calculation. Then pump house, steel column. If the pump house steel column is there, they are using 25 to 70 mm square copper wire, or they are using GI flat also. Then building. On top of building, you can use 25 by 3 or 25 by 6 flat. On top of building, it is usually for lightning protection. Cable tray, earthing, again, as I told you, cable tray, cable trench, main earth grid, main LV switchboard, you have to do the sizing, okay? You have to do the actual sizing calculation. Now, I quickly tell you about the short circuit calculation for motor. Okay. Now, let's say there is a transformer here. Transformer impedance, if it is 4%, okay, you have to convert this impedance from per unit method to absolute method. Okay. So I will share some material with you about this per unit method. You can go through that. Okay. So whenever there is a fault here, see, the transformer is feeding a panel is feeding a motor via a cable. Now this cable is a 3-core 50 mm square cable. Okay. The short circuit calculation is a big subject. So I will briefly tell you, because in 10-15 minutes I cannot teach this subject, but I will tell you it briefly, okay, since it is connected to RC. So if there is a fault here in the motor, then what all impedance will come into picture? Number one, this cable impedance. Okay. Number two, the impedance from here, the cable impedance here. Number three, the transformer per unit impedance. Where do I get the transformer impedance? I will get it from the transformer standard or the transformer data sheet. Okay. And where do I get the impedance of the cable? I will get it from the cable catalog. Okay.
Now, sir, one question.
Yeah, please.
This 4% is 4% of what?
I will tell you. 4% means it is 4% means it is, you have to convert that percentage to per unit. It becomes 0.04 per unit, and per unit you have to convert to absolute value. Okay.
Yeah.
So when they say 4%, 4% is equal to 0.04. per unit, and per unit, if you have to convert to absolute value, it is per unit is, there's a formula, absolute impedance divided by base impedance. Base impedance is kV square by MVA. Okay. So I will give you about that per unit. This one I will just give you some basic. This one, okay.
Yeah,
I will give you some link. Okay, which you can read. So now this 50 mm square cable. Cable impedance normally is given in milliohms per meter or ohms per kilometer. So you have to know the length of this from the total. Let's say this is 50 meter. So this impedance is 0.04 ohm. Okay. Now coming to the transformer. See, transformer is now, okay. Sorry. Now what I'm doing is this impedance of the cable, I'm going to convert it to per unit. Okay. What is the base impedance of this? Base impedance is kV square by MVA. kV for this system, it is a 415 volt system, so it is 0.4. 0.4 square by 0.5 MVA, because it is 500 kVA system. So base impedance of this system is 0.32 ohms. So per unit impedance of the cable is 0.04 ohms by 0.32. It is 12.5%.
Okay, so just you are recording it, right, sir?
Yeah, yeah, I'm recording. So transformer per unit impedance and cable per unit impedance, I will add, it will become 16.5%. So 1 by Z is 6. In other words, the fault current will be 6 times the base current. What is the base current? It is 500 kVA by root 3 V. So it is basically P divided by root 3 V. So it is 721 amps. So fault current will be 721 into 6, it will be 4.8 kV. Okay. So I'm just telling you in brief, because this fault calculation is a very deep subject again. Okay. Now, once you get.
Sir, just a second.
Yeah, please.
Sir, it was 500 divided by root 3.
Yeah, 500 kVA divided by root 3 V. V is in both KK cancels here. Okay. The formula, this is basic for electricity. Formula for current is equal to power divided by times voltage.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so from that you get 721 ohms, and then basically I have done for, there are two methods of doing fault calculation. One is symmetrical method, one is per, three methods, symmetrical, per unit and absolute method. I have done the calculation using per unit method. Okay. Okay, then see, now I have to size my earthing conductor. It has to take, what is the fault current here? 4.8 kA, right? So my, if there is a fault here at the motor terminal, it will be 4.8 kA. So I have to size my conductor. It has to be suitable to carry 4.8 kA for 1 second. Okay, so fault, though fault will get cleared in 100 milliseconds, I have to size it 1 second. So I choose one core 35 square mm or one core 50 mm square for the earthing of this motor. Okay. Then see if you,
sir.
Yeah.
Sir, but the grounding grid that is near the motor will be sized for the design fault current. Is
yes,
that
yes,
correct?
Yes, you are correct. I am talking about the conductor which will connect the motor to the grid.
Okay. Okay, sir.
So remember, whenever you are, see, if you blindly, people will select the cable, no? Then there will be a problem. If I go
okay.
after the table, I will choose 25 mm square. But if I size, I have to use 35 or 50 mm square. That is the reason I'm telling. For motors, please do the sizing. And remember, whenever you are close to switchgear, please do the verification. Don't just assume some value. So it is always
sir,
better. Yeah.
Sir, just one last question now. If the fault current in the motor, which will go to the ground, will be equal to the fault current which we have here in case of solidly ground earth, correct?
Yes, yes, yes. It is solidly grounded because it is a 450 volt system. Had this be 3.3 kV or 6.6 kV and the neutral would have been earth through a resistor, the fault current would have been less.
Okay, sir. Okay.
That time, okay, you can go as per the table.